Today we're going to learn how to remove dark wrinkles from under eyes, all with the power of Affinity Photo on iPad. If you'd like to follow along with the same image I'll be using today, I've left a download link in the video description. For this lesson, our goal is to remove the dark wrinkles from under this woman's eyes. Really though, this is two separate things that we need to accomplish. First, we need to brighten the dark skin under her eyes, and then second, we need to remove the wrinkles. To do this, we're going to use frequency separation, which allows us to independently work on the colors and textures in our photo. Frequency separation can be a little tricky at first, but stick with me because I promise this method produces by far the best results. To begin our edit, we need to duplicate our image. To do this, just press and hold anywhere on the photo, and then press Duplicate. Inside the Layer Studio, you can see that we now have two copies of our image. On the duplicate copy, we're going to apply frequency separation. To do this, come to the Filter Studio and scroll down a little ways. Then select Frequency Separation. As you can see, Affinity is splitting our photo into two halves. The gray half on the left is our high frequency layer and contains all of the fine texture in our photo. The right half is our low frequency layer, which contains all of the color in our image. We can see this better if we zoom in a ways. Notice how the gray, high frequency layer has all of the woman's skin texture on it, while the low frequency layer just has her skin colors. If you want to increase the gap between the high and low frequency layers, you can increase the radius in the context toolbar. This puts even more of the photo's textures in the high frequency layer. I'll keep mine set to the default of 2 pixels though, and then apply our frequency separation by pressing on the check mark. Inside the Layer Studio, you can see that we now have high and low frequency layers. This is perfect because now we can work on the dark colored skin and the wrinkles independently of each other. Let's group our high and low frequency layers together. To do this, just swipe on each layer and then press on the Group button at the top of the studio. If we turn the group off and on, you can see that the high and low frequency layers make an exact copy of our original image when they are combined together. Now the stage is finally set for us to begin editing this portrait. We'll first work on the dark skin tones, and then work on the wrinkles. I'll open our group up, and then select the low frequency layer, which contains all of the color in our image. Now we'll make a new blank pixel layer right above it. To do this, press on the big plus button, and then select Pixel Layer. On this new pixel layer, we're going to paint good skin colors on top of the dark skin tones. We'll need the paintbrush tool to do this. Now in the context toolbar, set the flow to 1%. This allows us to paint just 1% of our paint with each brush stroke, making it easy to gradually layer paint where we want it. Even 1% might be too much paint though, so I recommend you lower the opacity of our paint to 25% as well. You can also make your brush size a little smaller. And make sure your hardness is set to 0% so your paint strokes have a nice soft edge. Believe it or not, at this point we're just going to sample a skin color and then begin painting. Nothing fancy here, just painting. To select a skin color, tap on the color circle in the context toolbar and then tap and drag on the color picker to sample a skin color. Now, begin painting with our bright skin color, covering up the dark skin tones under her eyes. And of course, you can always sample new colors while painting. This will help to keep things looking even more natural by mixing a variety of colors. When you're done painting, you can turn this pixel layer off and on to see what a dramatic improvement we've already made to our image. If your painting turned out like mine, though, you might be able to see a slight edge going around the area we painted. To fix this, come to the Layer Effects Studio and then press on Gaussian Blur. Then bring the blur radius up to 10 pixels. That will blur our paint strokes so they completely blend in with the rest of the image. If we come back to the Layer Studio though, I want to point out why painting worked so well. Remember, our frequency separation placed all of the woman's skin texture on the high frequency layer, which is the layer above the pixel layer we painted on. Because of this, our paint does not cover any of her skin texture. It only adds color. If we painted directly on top of the original photo, this technique would not work nearly as well. Now that we've fixed the dark skin tones, our next step is to remove the wrinkles from under her eyes. To do this, we'll use our high frequency layer. First, select the high frequency layer and then duplicate it by pressing anywhere in the document and selecting Duplicate. Right now though, this isn't what we want. By duplicating the textures in our image, we've actually made the wrinkles even more noticeable. To fix this, press on the three circles at the top left of the Layer Studio, and then change the layer's blend mode from Linear Light to Normal. Then come back to our Layer Options. Now we just need to make this duplicate layer a child layer to our original high frequency layer. To do this, drag the duplicate layer on top of the original one and release your finger once you see a blue line running across the layer. Now our duplicate high frequency has no effect on the image. I'll show you in a minute why we went through the trouble of making a duplicate high frequency layer. To work on the wrinkles in this photo, make sure you have the duplicate high frequency layer selected, and then get out the clone brush tool. With this tool, we can sample parts of the skin that have good texture and duplicate those good skin textures across the wrinkles. First, press and hold somewhere on the photo to sample some skin texture. Then, make sure your brush settings are good to go in the context toolbar. I recommend you use 100% opacity, 100% flow, 0% hardness, and a brush size of about 100 pixels. Now we can begin painting. Using this technique works extremely well because we're painting skin texture that occurs naturally on top of the wrinkles. We also don't need to worry about our colors being thrown off because we've already separated those to a different layer. The biggest tip I can give you with this part is to sample new skin textures often. This will keep the skin looking natural and not like an exact duplicate of the skin right beneath it. Just press and hold on a part of the skin whenever you need a new sample. You can also change your brush size as needed. As you can see, this worked incredibly for removing the wrinkles. But now it's time to bring back some of the wrinkles. This might sound odd, but as a portrait retoucher, we never want our images to look fake. If this woman or her family were to see her without any wrinkles, they would know right away this image has been edited. Instead of making the photo look fake, all we want to do is portray this woman in the best light. And I can guarantee you, when she pictures herself, she doesn't imagine deep wrinkles on her face. That's why it's our job to decrease the wrinkles, but not take them away completely. To bring back some wrinkles, press on the three circles at the top left, and then lower the opacity until you think the photo looks realistic. I'll set mine to 75%. Then we can come back to our layer options. Our wrinkle removal is looking much more natural now. As a side note, this is why we had to make a duplicate copy of our high frequency layer. Without a duplicate copy of it, we wouldn't be able to fade some of the wrinkles back in, because lowering the opacity of the original high frequency layer would lower the opacity of all the textures in our image. If you want, you can also lower the opacity of the recoloring we did underneath her eyes. Just select the layer we painted on, and then press on the three circles again to lower the opacity. I know this technique is a little tricky, but you have to admit that the results look great. If you're new to Affinity Photo, you might want to check out our beginner's guide before trying edits like this. Our guide will get you up to speed with all the most important tools and features in Affinity Photo, so you can quickly and easily edit your pictures. To finish up this video though, let's zoom out a little and see a before and after of our work. Here's the original image, and here it is with our retouching applied. And now you can practice using the techniques we learned in this video to edit the wrinkles underneath the other eye on your own. Thanks for watching, my friends, and I'll see you in the next Affinity Revolution tutorial.